डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद वेरिएबल कोफिशिएंट। डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद वेरिएबल कोफिशिएंट्स। नाउ आई विल शो यू हाउ टू अप्रोच दिस टाइप ऑफ इक्वेशन एंड एग्जैक्टली वी आर हैविंग अ स्पेशल नेम फॉर दिस टाइप ऑफ इक्वेशन एंड दैट नेम इज कोशीज यूलर इक्वेशन और द कोशीज इक्वेशन। यू कैन से कोशीज यूलर इक्वेशन और इट इज ओनली कोशीज इक्वेशन। ओके एंड इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंट, अ क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड फ्रॉम दिस कॉन्सेप्ट इन 2021 ऑल्सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, राइट? सो लेट्स अप्रोच योर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद वेरिएबल कोफिशिएंट। वॉट एग्जैक्टली द डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन विद वेरिएबल कोफिशिएंट? लेट मी राइट डाउन अ फॉर्म फॉर यू। एक्स टू द पावर एन डी एन वाई बाई डी एक्स एन, एक्स टू द पावर एन माइनस वन डी एन माइनस वन डी एक्स एन माइनस वन and so on we can approach, right? So here we can easily see, okay, we can make here constant also a1. So a1 into x to the power n minus 1, right? And when we approach it, it will be, last will be a n y is equals to, it can be possible, it can be 0 or it can be q, right? So the when it will be 0, we will find only and only cf. When it will be not zero, we will find CF plus PI. But generally, we consider the equation with the zero only. That's why in our syllabus, we will consider this type of equation only, right? Where we will find out only and only CF, okay? Now, let's approach with the equation. You can see here x power n minus 1. Then after that, if you want to write down, it will be a2 x to the power n minus 2 d n minus 2 y by dx n minus 2 and so on, it will be a n y is equals to 0. So you can see here we are having a variable with the derivative also. Earlier when we discuss about the differential equation with constant coefficient, there was only a1, a2, a3 or k1, k2, k3, right? There was no not at all any variable, right? But here we can see x power n minus 1, x power n minus 2, x power n, these are the variables only, guys, right? So we have to approach with the variable only. So for these type of equation, we are having a particular method to solve or particular method to approach the solution. Let's approach to the solution, dear students. So yes, let's approach to the solution. So for these equations, we are having particularly a pattern of solution. So let's have discussion on the solution. So we have to follow few steps. So steps to solve differential equation with variable coefficient. Let's approach it, guys. So when we approach it, it will become what? When we approached it, the first of all you have to put x is equals to e to the power z or z is equals to log x. Okay, first of all you have to put wherever in the equation x is there, you will put x is equals to e to the power z or z is equals to log x, my dear students. Yes, x is equals to e to the power z or z is equals to log x, the first thing is there. Yes, and the second thing will be wherever we have x d by dx, dear students, we will put q. Okay, now let me tell you, in a different books, the notation are different. Some people just take it as a D, capital D. Some books or some persons take it as a capital D, right? Or theta or Q. So I used to take it as a Q only, right? It is capital Q. So x d by dx is equals to Q. Wherever we are having x square d2 by dx2, we will put Q into q minus 1, right? Okay, so it will be q into q minus 1. Similarly, whenever we have x cube d cube by dx cube, we will approach q minus 1, q minus 2 only, right? Similarly, we can go and so on, right? We can approach and so on. So hence, when we approach at the place, so when we put at the place of x d by dx q, the result will be, or your equation will be in the form of now q only, or q and x only, right? Okay, you can think that, ma'am, what is z and what is q? So let me tell you, z is the function of q and q is the function of x. So ultimately z is the function of x only, right? Dear students, okay, now let's approach to the question so it will be cleared in your mind. So the remaining things will be same. There is only slightly difference in the last step, okay, when we will let me show you here with this example. So you can see here we got the answer in the form of x, right? Here when we find the CF, we got the answer in the form of x only. But when we approach to this one, this method, right, when we have a variable equations, mean the differential equation with variable coefficients, then we will always have the answer or the final step in the form of z. And then we convert z, we will write down at the place of z is equals to log x, okay? So these are the only two steps which you have to follow. First of all, you have to put x is equals to e power z in the given differential equation. Second, you will first x is equals to e power z or z is equals to log x. Second, wherever x d by dx, you will put q. X square d2 by dx2, you will put q into q minus 1. X cube d2 by dx, d cube by dx cube, it will be q minus 1, q minus 2 and so on. Okay, let me show you one example so it will be clear in your mind. So find the solution of, based on this concept there are only 3 or 4 questions has been asked in the GATE examination, which I will show you here only. Okay, so find the solution of x square d2y by dx2 minus x dy by dx minus 3y is equals to 0. So I think you can easily identify that this is a differential equation with variable coefficient. How we can say? Because here we are having with the derivative we are having a variable. Similarly with the derivative we are having a variable, right? Yes. So let's approach it, guys. What it will become, we will write down, as we know very well, we have to put x is equals to e to the power z or z is equals to log x, and with that x d by dx we will put q. Here we are having x d by dx, x square d2 by dx2, we are having q minus 1, yes, and so on. Let's approach to the question. So it will be, dear students, x square d2y by dx2, so it will be q minus 1 minus x d by dx, it will be q minus 3 into y, we taken common already. So let's approach from here only. So let's write down the auxiliary equation. When we approach to the auxiliary equation, it will be q minus 1 minus q minus 3 is equals to 0. It will be q square minus q minus 3 is equals to 0. It will be q minus 1 and q minus 1, and when we take common minus, it will be q plus 3 is equals to 0. Hence we will get the factor as q is equals to 1, okay, let me write down complete now so that after that we will have discussion. So it will be q square minus 2q minus 3 is equals to 0, right? Isn't it? Yes. So it will be q square minus 2q minus 3 is equals to 0. We have to find the roots of this equation. So when we approach to the equation, the roots will be, let me show you here. If you want to write down in the form of m, you can write down in the form of m also. Or you want to continue with the q, you can continue with the q also, right? It's your choice. So it will be m square minus 3m plus m minus 3 is equals to 0. So it will be m minus 3, yes. When we take common m plus, it will be 1, m minus 3 is equals to 0, hence the root will be m minus 3 and m plus 1 is equals to 0. So the values will be 3 and minus 1, guys. Yes, exactly. So we are having different roots, real and different roots. So we know how to approach with the CF of real and different roots. So the CF will be, YCF will be what, dear students? It will be C1 e to the power 3z. Now just remember this thing only. As I already told you, whenever we are having this one in the real means in the normal equation, we approached just like this, c1 e to the power 3x n plus c2 e to the power minus x, right? But here we will write down in the form of z only, guys. So that's why I just write down here c1 e to the power 3z plus c2 e to the power minus z. Now at the place of z, we know very well what we can put. At the place of z, we know very well we can put either log x, or at the place of e power z, you can put x. So the equation final solution will be c1 e to the power 3z, means it is x cube. Yes, if you want to go with this one, you can write down 3 log x plus c2 e to the power minus log x. So when we approach it, it will be x cube, it will be c2 x power minus 1. So the final answer will be c1 x cube plus c2 by x. Clear, guys? So we are having c1 x cube plus c2 by x only. Is it clear? So this is the simple, exactly this is a very simple equation to approach. Just only one thing we have to remember, that after approaching this one, we should know that the CF will be in the form of Z only, right? Rather than finding the CF in the form of X, we will find always in the form of Z. Then after that, we will just put again the value of Z is equal to log X or e to the power, at the place of e to the power Z, we can put X. Okay, guys? Now let me show you one more example. We have one more example for this one. So when we have an equation, and now I will write down directly this time x cube d cube. Now d cube, it means we know very well d3y by dx cube plus 2x square d square minus xd plus 1 y is equals to 0. Now you know very well, I think, d cube is nothing but the derivative. This is the short form of d cube by d3y by dx cube. Yes, exactly, we know that. Okay, so let's approach for this one. So here again, we know very well, at the place of x cube d3y by dx3, or you can say x cube d cube, we will write down q minus 1, q minus 2, at the place of x square d2y by dx2, or x square d square, we will put q minus 1, yes, right, we know very well. And at the place of xd, means xdy by dx, or it is xd, we will put q only, right? So let's approach from here only, guys. Let's approach it. So when we approach from here, it will be x cube d cube, right? It will be x cube d cube, guys, right? So it will be q into q minus 1 into q minus 2 minus twice of q minus 1 minus it's not minus, it's plus, minus q plus 1 y is equals to 0. We are having exactly this equation. So let's approach it simple and let's make it simple. So it will be q square minus q, and q square minus q, we have to multiply q minus 2 plus 2q square minus 2q minus q and plus 1, y is equals to 0. Okay, so when we approach it, guys, what exactly we will have, let me write down here the final. It will be q cube, right? When we approach, it will be q cube minus 2q square, right? So let me write down q cube minus 3 q cube minus 2q square, and we already have a 2 square. So let me write down q cube minus 2q square minus q square, right? And minus minus plus 2q, okay, right? Plus 2q square minus 2q minus q plus 1, and if you want to write down it as a y is equals to 0, so it will be 2q square and 2q square will be cancelled out, right? So finally we will have q cube minus q square, 2q and 2q will be cancelled out, right? Okay, so we will have dear students, when we approach it, we will have q cube minus q square minus q plus 1 only, right? Yes, finally we are having like this. So when we find the auxiliary equation, it will be m cube minus m square plus m plus 1 is equals to 0. So how we will approach it? We can go for any method. We know very well m is equals to minus 1 is a factor of this one. So we can go with that method also. We can write down here m minus 1 3 times. So I think you are getting the point that this is the differential equation of higher order, right? Okay, so if you want to like this, or if you feel no, we will not approach like this, then you can approach directly also. You can take common m square from here, it will be m minus 1. You can take common minus 1 from here, it will be m minus 1 is equals to 0. Hence, you will have m square minus 1 into m minus 1 is equals to 0. So exactly this is a higher order equation. Higher order means it's an equation with having the order more than 2, right? That's why. So when we approach it, it will be m minus 1, m plus 1, and m minus 1 is equals to 0. Hence the answer will be m is equals to 1, 1 and minus 1. The answer will be, means the roots will be 1, 1 and minus 1, dear students. So we can find easily the CF from here. Yes. So the CF will be C1 plus C2 Z e to the power Z, because we are having repetitive roots, plus C3 e to the power minus Z. So I think now you are getting my point. Why I write down here Z? Because whenever we have a equation, whenever we have a differential equation with variable coefficient, we will always approach that in the form of, we will always approach the CF of that in the form of Z only. Okay, that's why we approached here Z only. So we can see here Z. So it will be YCF is equals to, so C1 plus C2 Z, at the place of Z you can write down e to the power Z, at the place of Z you can write down log X, and at the place of e to the power Z you will write down X only, plus C3 X to the power minus 1. So your final answer will be C1 plus C2 log X into X plus C3 by X. Hence it will be the CF only, right? So I think you guys are getting my point. It's a simple thing to approach, guys. Okay, so I think you will feel more comfortable in this method only. Clear? So we can easily approach this one. Okay, guys. Now, so let's approach to the one more example, and then we will go for the 3 GATE problems based on this one. So we have one small example. Let's have discussion on that one again. So x square d square, yes, plus xd minus 1. Let's approach this one, find the solution for this one, as we know very well. Now, can I write down here x square d square means it is x square d2y by dx2. We will put q into q minus 1. The process will be same. The process will be same. In the same way, you can do the 10 question also. You can do the 1 question also. The process will be same. Okay, there will be no variation. So that's why I told you in the earlier, dear student, that differential equation, the complete topic differential equation, is easily scorable, because there are exactly not so many variation in the questions, and exactly the questions will frame easily. Straightforward questions can frame from the differential equation only, right? So for x d means x dy by dx, it is equals to q. Let's approach to the solution. It will be q minus 1 plus q minus 1 y is equals to 0. Let's write down the auxiliary equation directly from here. It is m square minus m plus m minus 1 is equals to 0. M and m will be cancelled out. We will have m square minus 1 is equals to 0. We can write down m square is equals to 1. Hence we will have repetitive roots. M is equals to 1 and 1. So we will have repetitive roots m square. We will have m square is equals to 1, it means we will have m is equals to plus minus 1. So we will have the roots m is equals to plus minus 1. So the CF portion will be C1 e to the power Z plus C2 e to the power minus z. So hence you can write down the final solution c1x plus c2x to the power minus 1, because at the place of e power z we will write down x only, right? X is equals to e power z, we used to substitute. So that's why this will be the final answer. Done, guys?